Internal Revenue Service IRS tax tip dated September 4th, 2019. Taxpayers can use 2018 tax return to estimate 2019 withholding amount. Millions of people have filed their 2018 tax return, making this a prime time to consider whether their tax situation came out as expected. If not, taxpayers can use their finished 2018 return and the tax withholding estimator, there is a link here to the tax withholding estimator, to do a paycheck checkup ASAP and, if needed, adjust their withholdings. Having their 2018 return handy can make it easier for taxpayers to estimate deductions, credits, and other amounts for 2019. So in other words, this is another push from the IRS to say, hey, we have a withholding estimator, which really is really good for a projection even, and it's much more advanced than possibly other tools in the past. One of the tools that you can use in order to fill out the withholding estimator to adjust the withholdings is, of course, the prior year tax return, which can help you to consider some options that you might not understand or would have considered without that actual prior year tax return in front of you. Performing a paycheck checkup is a good idea for anyone who adjusted their withholdings in 2018, especially those who did so later in the year. So obviously, if there was any change to the withholdings in 2018, then you want to consider what's going on in the checkup portion now to see if those are if everything is going well within 2019 in terms of the amount of withholdings that are necessary. The way to do that is basically to run a projection. And the tool that the IRS has here is basically able to do that to some degree, run a projection to see if the withholdings that are currently there are going to be enough to cover the tax liability at the end of the year. Owed additional tax when they filed their tax return this year, had a refund that was larger or smaller than expected, had life changes such as marriage, childbirth, adoption, buying a home, or income changes. So obviously, in other words, if last year wasn't the refund wasn't what you expected, or if money was owed in the prior year, then of course things you want to do a checkup this year and make sure that everything is going well. If there are any substantial changes, such as things like an adoption, child, marriage, these are things that can substantially affect the withholdings, and therefore any of those types of changes are something you probably want to do some type of estimate for to see if the withholdings are at the proper amount at this point. Since most people are affected by the Tax Cuts and Job Act, all taxpayers should check their withholdings. They should do a checkup even if they did one in 2018. This especially includes taxpayers who have children and claim credits such as the child tax credit. The child tax credit is a very large credit for many people and could be very substantial. Therefore, it could fluctuate a lot. So you want to make sure that if that's going to be something that will be a factor in the return, you want to make sure you do the checkup with regards to it, because it can make a lot of changes within the return as well. Have older dependents, including children age 17 or older. Note that if there could be a change in the dependent status as children get older, it could change things like the credits related to them, and it could even change things like whether they're a dependent or not, and that could change things like the filing status. So those are all big, big factors you want to be able to consider if those are types of things that may be possible. Experience changes to itemized deductions this year. So if there's any, if you itemize deductions rather than have a standardized deduction, if there's going to be large changes to the itemized deduction, then of course you might want to do a checkup in that as well. Itemized deductions in the past are a two-income family. So anytime there's just a two-income family, it's actually a lot more confusing, because when you consider the withholdings in a W-2 withholding, it can be difficult to know how much to withhold in one withholding paycheck based on the pay tables, when your income, of course, is really your taxes based on all these other things, including the income of the spouse, which will complicate things a lot, and any other kind of deductions that would be involved as well. So two-income family can be actually a little bit difficult. You want to do that planning session to make sure that the withholdings are appropriate with regards to that. Have two or more jobs at the same time. Pretty much the same kind of situation if you have two or more jobs, because remember, the income tax system was kind of set up originally to have basically one job for the whole family, and that would be a bit more easy for the tax calculator to calculate. Now, if you have multiple jobs for one person, or if you have two people working, then of course it becomes more difficult to know what the withholding should be, given the fact that it's not just that one income that's being calculated on. That's why you basically need a whole projection to do. The new tool that the IRS is putting out there is a lot better at doing a fuller projection to estimate a more proper kind of withholding amount. Only work part-time for the year. Also note that obviously the withholding tables are actually built, you know, based on the concept that you're going to be working for the entire year generally. So if you calculate the amount of withholdings that you will have, and then you only work for part of a year, then it might be the case that that the withholdings that have been made are not proper, because the idea is that they're going to take some money out every paycheck. And the only way they can properly do that is basically to estimate that you're going to be working a similar amount of hours for the entire year, so that they can know what tax bracket you're in and withhold there. So you have some kind of part-time work, then the withholdings might be off. They might be too high, because they might have withheld based on the idea that your income would be too high. And then if you only work part of the year, they might be lower. But in any situation, it could throw things off. Have high income or a complex tax return. The higher your income is, the more complex the tax return generally is, the more kind of factors that will typically be involved, the more likelihood that you will be itemizing. So the higher it is, the more you want to take a look at the estimate to see if your withholdings are done well. The more higher it is, the more you're going to want to basically do a tax projection, because there could be substantial changes to basically double check and give a checkup on your withholdings. Now, again, the new tax tool is better at doing that than prior tax tools that were given through the IRS. You might want a tax projection, however, from a tax preparer who has tax software to help to run a tax projection. This tax withholding estimator works for most taxpayers. Those with more complex situations may need to use Publication 505, Tax Withholding and Estimated Tax, instead of the tax withholding estimator. This includes taxpayers who owe alternative minimum tax or certain other taxes, and people with long-term capital gains or qualified dividends. Taxpayers who can use the results from the tax withholding estimator to see if they need to complete a new Form W-4, Employees Withholding Allowance Certificate. So after you put the information into the tax withholding estimator, you're going to get some estimates. Do you need to change the withholdings? If you need to change the withholdings, then you're going to possibly need to get the W-4, and that's going to help you to basically change the withholding statuses. So note, it's the end of the year right now, obviously, so it's getting towards the last quarter of the year. So if you're going to adjust the withholdings, you're going to be adjusting them for the last quarter of the year. And if you're finding that the withholdings are short, then the goal is to basically adjust the withholdings enough so that the last quarter of the year withholdings will be enough to basically not owe any money and not have a resulting penalty or something like that, and interest based on an underpayment throughout the year. So the W-4 form is the form that would typically be filled out in order to adjust the withholding amounts with your employer. Now, note that the tendency or the what you want to go to try to do is say, hey, I need to adjust my withholdings. I would like to go discuss this with someone at the employer. But note, the employer will not typically talk taxes in terms of what your withholdings should be. All they will do, because of the Human Resources Department and their inability to give tax advice, will typically be, hey, just give me what the withholding amount is and I'll adjust it to that. I can't give you advice on tax advice on what your withholding should be. Therefore, you need to get the advice from a tax professional or from the IRS tool here, and then provide that information to the employer to make the adjustments to the withholding. So, and submit it to their employer. In some instances, the calculator may recommend they have an additional flat dollar amount withheld each pay period. Taxpayers give this form to their employer and do not send this form to the IRS. So this is a form W-4 that goes to the employer. The idea being, of course, that the employer then will be informed to take the money out of the paycheck, and they will be the ones that are actually making the payment from the gross earnings of the employee. More information can be found at the links below. A link to this information will be found in the description.